they had found. The head nurse spoke up, Celine was home. She could tell right away that I was bad at the bone. Bad at the bone. Bad at the bone.
Top of the morning to you laddies! Happy St. Patrick's Day to all of you fine lads and lassies out there! But yeah, anyway. Well, what's happening, hombres? Bridget here, and welcome back to my channel. Now, I decided to do something way, way different for a St. Patrick's Day this year because, well, the past two St. Patrick's Day specials that I've been doing, I've been kind of, well, shit. So, yeah, for that, this is gonna be a true St. Patrick's Day special because not only am I wearing this flat cap, which, by the way, I'm not trying to be Jacksepticeye. I'm just doing this for St. Patrick's Day. And this isn't exactly green, this Camaro shirt. And of which, I love the Camaro. It's still one of my favorite muscle cars of all time. But this is the closest to green that I got. So don't judge me, and don't scold me, because this is the closest to green that I got in terms of clothing. But anyway. So, yeah. And as y'all are probably hearing in the background of this part of the video right now, I am now totally, fully getting into the whole spirit of St. Patrick's Day, and as most of y'all know, I'm part British, Scottish, and Irish, so I got that, Irishness within me, the luck of the Irish with- the luck of the Irish within me, and also just the, hyper-energetic self of an Irishman. And not only that, and not only is today St. Patrick's Day, but today is also the anniversary of the worst aviation disaster in history to date, the Tenerife Airport Disaster, which I won't be getting into too much detail about the disaster because, well, this is a special to where it's just all about positivity and just spending time with family together. And so, yeah, I will actually leave a link down there in the description below for the documentary on the Tenerife Airport Disaster, which I actually will right now tell y'all of what exactly occurred, but I won't go into full detail because that's going to take me forever to actually explain it. So, on March 17th of 1977, today, at Tenerife in the Canary Islands, off the coast of Western Africa, two Boeing 747s collided at high speed on the same runway, killing 583 people. Yeah. Just think about that. 583 deaths. That is insane. And yes, it's very, very sad, but because of this, human error, technology failing, and super bad weather. But, like I said, I won't be going into complete detail about the disaster because I will let the documentary of the disaster, which again, I will be leaving that link down in the description below. It's called Crash of the Century. It's really, really interesting. Now, I don't think y'all find watching air disasters and learning about air disasters interesting, but to me, since I am so fucking smart, and since I pretty much know about everything, and since I'm just this huge body of knowledge, I am proud of knowing all this, because if I didn't know all this, I would be just a... Well, I would be someone who just doesn't know anything, and I'll be just... And I would be just a complete dumbass. But, you know, for that. Oh, and also, guys, we just hit 580 subscribers, just 20 away from 600. Guys, y'all are absolute mad lads, just coming on in here, subscribing, and turn on notifications. That is insane. 580 subscribers in almost 4 years. Well, about 4 years of my time on YouTube. Thank you all so much for all of your love and support. It is just insane. And even to the majority of my subscribers that don't watch my videos, thank you so much for hitting that subscribe button and for sticking around on my channel. And even sometimes watching my videos, I could not be more thankful. And let alone today on St. Patrick's Day. So anyway, at least I am actually going to be doing something very, very different here on the channel. And for the very first time ever, we are going to be playing Fallout 4. That's right, everyone. Now, I've been getting hugely back into this game, and I've never done Fallout 4 here on the channel before. But this is the very first video on Fallout 4 that I am doing for y'all today. And as y'all can see, I have dog meat here. And he's looking snazzy as always. And I also got Strong here, this big guy, and his dog here, Hun, which is also a mod. And I have Kate here. And since today is St. Patrick's Day, I'm bringing this tough, badass Irish girl with me on this adventure. And the two gun mods, which I have is the M16. But this one is what I have named the Titsington M16 American Warhorse. Now, Titsington is actually a fictional gun company, which I just came up with, courtesy of Jungle Tits, which shout out to you, and I really do hope that you get the channel back. Oh, and check out what it says there on the back of the stock. OP for 69. 69. And also have the Titsington CS5, which this is also a gun mod called the CS5 Standalone Sniper Rifle, and I named this one the Widow's Kiss Mark II. And without further ado, the main part of this mod, well, this video that we are doing now is a quest mod called Vault 82, the something cool, I can't really remember, but we're now on the south of Rocky Narrows Park, and we are now about to go inside and I'll start this mod. So Gray Garden Homestead, here we go. Time to get this mod. Oh, a desk fan for Jungle Tits, which I'm collecting those, by the way. And another one. Okay, it did say that, well, the mod description did say something about it starting down here. Well, here, in this house. So, it should start here. Well, at least according to what the mod said to actually start this. Okay, there's the bathroom, which I'll take all that. That noise you're hearing is John's dog, by the way. Okay, hang on. I actually need to look at the mod again. Because, well, I actually do want to start doing Fallout 4. Because I know this game is still very popular, and that millions and, like, billions of people are playing this game. Which, the modding community for this game is absolutely amazing. And, like, the mods that people make for this game are just absolutely phenomenal. Like, phenomenal mod making for this game. Now, in terms of mods, I have, like, over, somewhere around over 120 to about 130 mods. Mostly, ones to make, the Commonwealth look more alive and not like some dead, barren wasteland. So, where is it? Where is it? Vault 28, the Absent Ghoul. To start your quest, visit the Fredrickson place. A map marker has been added to your Pip-Boy on the western side of the Commonwealth, south of Rocky Narrows Park. Oh. Oh, that place! Well, I'm stupid, apparently. So, I'm sorry for wasting all this time in there. Well, I have played this game a lot, but I don't know it that well, so shut up. But, yeah, anyway, let's get this started. Oh yeah, I also have, a mod that makes me jump higher than normal. Alright, let's get this started.
Oh, sure, just come on in, why don't you? My day was bad. Get this, actually knock on a door, so just open again.
Okay, hang on. Let me, just take off. Room for Chris. Oh, I'm sorry. It says from the outside. I assume this place was abandoned. No offense.
Abandoned? You people. I'll have you know, this humble home is as sturdy as the day I bought it. I mean, who cares if all the windows are boarded up with these holes in them? Which adds character, you know? Actually, seeing as you are trespassing here, I don't suppose you'd be willing to do this old man a favor.
Well, I guess I am the home invader here. I'd be happy to help. The Absent Ghoul. Okay. Here we go, guys. A teapot for Silly Cat. And another one for Silly Cat. I'll just take all that pre-worm money. Because why not? I collect those. Oh, wow, look at that. Why is there a mini nuke under there? 10mm, and alarm clock, I'll take that for, well, junk. Take all that. And that. I'll take these new Coca-Cola. Oh, look at these model boats. Hey, that's cool. Whoa, lots of politics here. And another desk fan. Okay, here's a Mr. Handy model. Okay, so Edward's 2077 journal. Let's take a listen. Oh. August 15th, 2077. Chris and I sent our goodbyes to the Robinsons this morning as they were bundling up their furniture into the back of a moving truck. It's such a shame. Another family lost to Sanctuary Hills. Mr. Robinson was nice enough to give us some parting advice, though. It's his opinion that Chris and I are just being stubborn and that we should simply drop our cause. It took everything in my power to not to sock him right in the gut, but thankfully, Chris was holding my hand. When will people realize that we will not be pressured into leaving our own home? Is nothing sacred anymore? Okay, that was interesting. August 29th, 2077. We received another letter this morning from the Housing Association with an even bigger purchase offer. Damn fools. They honestly, I believe, we're holding out for more money. September 5th, 2077. I woke up this morning just in time to see the Abel family leaving. Our neighborhood is down to just two families now. Us and the Whitfields. They've already started tearing down the other homes to make way for that monstrosity behind us. The noise is horrendous, but I still don't care. Even if they have to build directly over our damn roof, we are not going anywhere. Yet. October 20th, 2077. So we received a different kind of letter today. It was from the Housing Association again, but this time, the letter had a Vault-Tec stamp on the corner of the page. Apparently, if we agree to sell up, we are being offered a placement in one of their swanky vaults near Sanctuary Hills. I threw the letter into the trash before even showing Chris. To hell with Vault-Tec. Whoa, okay. Apparently they're showing a bit of hostility. I've actually changed my mind, so I'm actually not going to be reading all that, because that's going to take a long time for the video to actually truly get to where it needs to go. But anyway, okay, so where's the next spot that we need to go? Relay Tower 1DL-109. And yes, I know that was close by, but why bother going there? Careful, guys. Don't want to get burned. Oh. I'll just put my mask slash scarf back on, so. Okay. Oh, shit. Whoa. Oh. Okay, I thought I was. I'm able to, like, jump over the. Oh, God. Well, thankfully, I have this travel bag mod, which has a lantern on the back, so. Here we go. And I'll get my M16 out, in case anything decides to jump us. There's a beer bottle here. God damn, there's a lot of shit here. I'll take that fusion core.
Okay, elevator. Oh god, what the hell? Strong? Strong, where'd you go, big guy? Oh. Oh god, what the hell? What the hell? Oh. Apparently he wasn't happy that we made it to his home. Okay, so let's explore this. Thankfully, I have the open everything mod. Another desk fan, and another one. Well, as they say, Strong, one man's junk is another man's treasure.
Please be nothing.
And yes, that's Strong's dog howling. Jesus Christ. You leave dog meat alone. Take all that. Okay, another elevator. And another one. Well, that went to nowhere. research. No, don't want to pick that. Because I have unlocked everything. The mod. What the hell? Oh god!
Let's do this.
Oh god.
What the?
Oh my god, that was amazing! Okay, some more rounds from my sniper, and two more folders from Mr. J. Oh god! Yeah, I forgot that there is gore in this game. So yeah. Okay, screening. Alright. What the hell? There we go. Okay, I'll just collect everything. Dogmeat, you're running in place. Okay, now let's see if there's anything else here that I might be able to take. Okay, is there anything down here? Oh, Jesus! A glowing ghoul, well, a bloated glowing ghoul just came out of nowhere from the corner there. Jesus. Wait, is this the vault that I was talking about? Or maybe this was a different one. Okay, so... Commissary. Whatever that is, I have no idea. Oh!
Why, hello there. Would you be interested in seeing my wares?
Oh, God.
It's dusty, but I'm sure everything tastes just fine.
Well, this was the last place I expected to find a merchant, but sure.
great stuff. You may peruse it to your leisure.
Jesus Christ! Dude, his voice is creepy as all hell. Sell all that, take these, and the shotgun shells. A napalmer, which is the flamethrower, by the way. Anything else there? Nope. I'll take this corn and that gourd, and the amoeba fruit, radway, razor grain, and stim packs. These bobby pins. Okay, I'll just sell these just to make some space. Okay, I'll sell those two backpacks as well. Okay, irradiated blood, psycho buff, purified water. Okay. Okay, I'll stick all that. Why are there mini noobs lying around? And why would you put bullets inside of a cash register? Like, why?
Perfect.
A Tesla signs a magazine there. Oh, God. Okay. Well, this place is interesting. Another bone for Chris. Oh, God. Jesus. This leads back outside. Guys! Jesus Christ! Dude, then... Jesus Christ, now that was a bloodbath. Dude, not take things! God damn it, I just... Stay calm, eh? Not this time, nope, not today. Okay, I don't need any of that because those are chems. Man, that was a real bloodbath. Really? Another broom for Chris. Oh, hello. I'll take you. Take these, and take those. Excuse me, Kate. Okay, I'll now check down here. Take these. Take those. Is it really everything that's here in this vault? Because this... exploration of the vault is short. I'll also be taking all that. Take these. And also all that. Excuse me, hon. Whoa, dog meat. Jesus. Dog Jesus. Okay, it then just circles all the way back around. Just take all that. There's an empty one in there. Oh. 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 Wait, we're strong. Jesus Christ. God damn, these elevators are tiny. Jesus Christ! Jesus Christ! Out of nowhere! Holy shit! Jesus Christ! Huh? Wait, we're strong.
You hit like a railroad!
Good shit, dog meat! Good shit! Ain't no good cherry, which I'll take that. Okay, that guy died taking a shit while looking through all that. Really? Take all of that. That's impact. And another dust fan. Can't take that folder that was in there. Take everything that's in these. And I'll also be taking this as well. Jesus Christ, okay, he just flipped that entire gurney. Holy shit. Damn, dude. Can't do that to me. Surprise, motherfucker! Take that. Okay, that's an elevator. This is an elevator too? Yes, it is. Huh? Something's ghosting us. Kay, is that a reference to something? Another breath of grace. Oh! Oh, don't drop the soap! Oh. Exactly, Strong. I guess. Yep, that guy taking his shit while holding that gun in his hand, in case he got robbed. Or anything. Well, I don't think getting robbed while you're taking a shit would be the best, well, most pleasant experience. But, whatever. Okay, most of this is just a, it's like a maze, because all this just goes in the exact same direction. But now let's take out the Widow's Kiss, because this thing is gonna kick ass. Residential is where we're going first. Now, I know that y'all are here for the quest mod, but since I love exploring, I'll be exploring this vault with Kate, Dogmeat, Strong, and his dog Hun. The sound of this thing. shot there. God damn, this thing is loud. Like, really loud. Take that stim pack off of you and that, and those 10mm rounds. Not sponsored by Nuka-Cola, by the way. Because Nuka-Cola is fake. Or is it? Oh, shit. I'll be taking all those bandanas. As well as that. Black rim glasses. And another broom for Chris. Chris the key, by the way. I'm just trying to see if there's anything inside these. Okay, there was another teddy bear for Sloth in there. Okay, that's everything that was inside those. Okay, back to the M16. I have no idea what all these terminals are here for. What the hell is going on in there? Nope. Jesus Christ, I'm fucking fat. A bastard over here. Nothing. Another Nuka-Cola, which I'll take that. Oh, look at this. Toy Cars, that's awesome. Jesus Christ, blew her fucking head off. What the fuck is going on here? What did you say now? Sit down. Another room for Chris. You know, back to that room of where I found those tapes. Oh wow, boxing ring. No, did not mean to sit down there. God damn it. Take those. But is there really still someone in here? Another desk fan. Let's do this. Crikey. Jesus Christ. Oh shit. Sorry, dog mate. Just got caught in my sights there, and I was on something that a couch over there. Which I'll just leave him to it. Caps. A tiny teddy bear for Sloth. and another one there in this car. Okay, that's a cute little stop sign there. And Astron's now just chilling out there. Another broom for Chris. Oh, here they are. Okay, so... Alright, the new squirrel, tape one. What's this?
Hello. My name is Storytime Simon, and I hope you like stories, because I love to tell stories. This one is called The New Squirrel. Come with me on this magical adventure. There once was a young squirrel named Ricky, who lived in a big oak tree in the city park. Ricky was a brown squirrel and lived in the oak tree with all his brown squirrel friends and family. Every day, Ricky would look out from the top of his tree and wonder what kind of squirrels lived in other trees. The older squirrels warned Ricky that the squirrels in other trees were thieves and liars. They were never to be trusted. Ricky had a rebellious heart and would not form his opinions based on anecdotal evidence. End of holotape. Please insert holotape 2. Storytime Simon here. Welcome back. And here it is, part 2 of The New Squirrel. One night, a red squirrel appeared at the bottom of Ricky's oak tree and woke Ricky and his family. Oh, please help me, said the red squirrel. I am lost and have nowhere to go. The elders were quick to turn the red squirrel away. Ricky scurried down the trunk of his tree and stood firm next to the red squirrel. He yelled up at the elder squirrels, how could you turn him away? Just because he's from another tree, he needs our help. Affected by Ricky's assuredness and determination, the elders agreed to take in the red squirrel. The red squirrel thanked Ricky for standing up for him. You won't regret this, he said. End of holotape. Please insert holotape 3.
Here we go.
Storytime Simon here with the exciting conclusion to The New Squirrel. Tomorrow we can get to know each other and become best friends, said Ricky to the red squirrel. The red squirrel made a sound that Ricky took for agreement, and the two squirrels curled up to sleep.
Aww.
Later that night, Ricky woke up to the sound of leaves rustling in the oak tree. He looked around. The red squirrel was gone. Ricky surveyed the landscape below and saw a pack of glowing eyes approaching the base of his tree. Cats! Ricky heard a voice from a nearby tree. It was the red squirrel. I'm sorry, he said. They were following me and I couldn't bring them to my tree. They would have eaten my family. As the cats ascended the tree and began to devour Ricky's friends and family, Ricky reflected on his decisions. His last words were, I really wish I would have trusted my elders. The end.
Okay, well, that was interesting. So, well, that was actually kind of a fucked up story, to be honest. But anyone else in the comments who says otherwise, I apologize. But that's just my opinion. What the hell? Okay, lots of Nuka-Cola here. Let's take everything that's here. You know what, that's a fan. Take all that. And another desk fan. Another desk fan. Another desk fan. Oh. All those are Pip-Boy games. Okay. That's actually pretty cool. I had no idea that you could do that in this game. Yep, it is a human thing, Strong. But, as I said before, Strong, One man's junk is another man's treasure. Even dog meat agrees, as he's now just pushing me around. Okay, I'm now just taking a quick look around here to see if I missed anything. Oh shit, what the hell?
I don't think I won't hurt
you. Nope, because I just heard you. Bitch. Another broom for Chris. What the hell? Anyone inside these stalls? Except you. I don't think he's gonna be fighting better anytime soon, Strong. And another burn for Chris. Take everything here. Got that and that. I guess I could take that Vault-Tec lab coat as well. Why not? Okay, now, before we talk to this girl, Annabelle, I need to check out all the other rooms here to see if I'm missing anything. And so far, it doesn't seem like I'm missing anything. Okay, I thought I saw something there. Take all that. Oh shit. Shit, what the hell? Oh, fuck. Whoops. Got good. Yes, I just managed to grab all of those. Strong. Oh, I'll just put my gun away here. Okay. Now we can talk to this girl, Annabelle. Now we can talk to her. Except, of course, I needed to find her, though. God damn, this place is like a maze. Jesus. What is this? Oh. It just leads back onto the main hall, like. Are you kidding me? Jesus Christ. Hey, there she is. Oh. And I need to take off my mask. There we go.
Excuse me. Well, I can't see if you're armed or not, but you sure made one hell of a noise coming down that hall. What a way to wake up the entire vault. Seriously, good job.
I'm armed, but you're not in any danger from me.
Oh, I wasn't worried, Dean. I know you're blind, but if you test me, you won't even see it coming. Anyway, now that you're here, I don't suppose you'd be willing to do me those small favors?
Well, it's the least I can do after giving you a scare. What do you need?
Great. You see, when I was a child growing up here, my father was the senior engineer. He always wanted me to follow in his footsteps.
Aww.
Every night after class, he set up a small table for me in his workshop and show me how to create circuit boards. On the day he died, he was carrying one circuit board that I'd ever finished in his toolbox. It should still be there, somewhere on the lower levels.
Locate the circuit board for Annabelle. Okay. Alright, so another quest to do, and that's what we're gonna be doing now.
somewhere.
And down we go. Oh. Jesus Christ, this elevator is tiny. Okay. Wait, we've already been here. God damn it. I haven't been here yet. No, I didn't mean to. Another dustpan. His typewriter, but it ain't a Carlisle.
There we go.
Let's take all that. And a little room for Chris. Say all that. A teddy bear with a cone on his head. Search all of these. That doesn't look too comfortable, but okay. Not a chance. Another desk fan. Another desk fan. A dustpan that was in the garbage. Whoa, what the hell? Damn, okay.
Wait there. Over here. Hold position.
Okay, some X1 power armor, which I'm not gonna collect that. But I've also decided not to collect all that, because that's gonna just waste my time. Wait, haven't I? Wait, I have been here before. But I don't recall being here.
Heads up. Come on.
Ahem. is there anything down here? Jesus Christ, these fuckers are everywhere! Like, holy shit! Christ! Another desk fan. And another broom for Chris. Too late, Sean, because he's already dead. Okay, I'm just making sure that there's nothing here that I miss. Down we go, I guess. Okay, this one's gonna take a while. Invisible wall that's there. Oh. What the hell happened here? Fuck me! Fucking shit, dude! Fuck me! Fuck these ghouls, man! Jesus! These fucking ghouls! Fuck me! Dude, that ghoul, I did not see him. Jesus! Hey, Kate. Goddamn, Kate, you're looking intimidating today. Alright, Annabelle. Oh, hey, Kate. Oh, Jesus! I think I found it. It was in a toolbox, just like you said.
What? Seriously? Here, let me hold it. Oh my. This is it. I can't believe
something to remember my father by, I can actually start thinking about leaving this damn purgatory. Thank you so much for giving the board back to me. I can't do an awful lot with it in my current condition, but it means the world to me.
No problem. Cute cat there. Okay, but Jesus, John. Mr. Frederick's men's basement. What the hell? These stimpaks lying around. Take all this. Oh, what the hell? Does this even go anywhere? So far, it doesn't seem like it. What the hell? What the fuck? Fuck me! Fucking mole rats! Jesus! Jesus Christ! I really hate the mole rats. I hate them. Fucking mole rats! Jesus! God, I hate those little fuckers. Fucking mole rats! Fuck me! Ugh, I hate these mole rats! I really hate them. God, these little fuckers are everywhere! That's interesting. So apparently that goes somewhere. Well, that's on that up. Excuse me, big guy. And I don't know where dog meat is. Whoa, this is pretty. Ballstone, Well, we humans love to go swimming, Strong. And you should try it sometime. Oh, Jesus, Kate. What the hell? Fuck. Well, I guess I'll have to find a way out. Well, out of this. Whoa, K.O. is Nuka Cola like dog meat. Oh, wait. God damn it. Another broom for Chris. Note. I've locked myself in here for safety. Everyone is going fucking insane. It started with Security Chief Bell, and then it just kept happening. I've never seen anything like this. I hope security will come for me soon. And I wish I'd packed my office up with actual food instead of my vices. Damn. Nobody came. Oh, that's so sad. Oh my God. At least she had a 10mm. So she died with a source of protection. And she died doing what she loved. God. Poor teacher. Damn. Guess the luck of the Irish wasn't with her. God! Hunt, move your fat ass! Move your fat fucking dog asses. Seriously. Oh, Jesus! No. Okay, I think we might be getting closer to the end of this mod, as I just collected another folder from Mr. J there. So yeah, I think we might be getting closer to the end of this quest mod. shit. Wow. Oh, hey guys. Hey Kate. Jesus Christ. Okay, I think that might be the end of this mod. Entirely sure where to begin with this, but I'll do my best. I found your husband. I found Edward. As it turns out, that person he'd been communicating with over his radio wasn't a person at all. It was a computer, and it was manipulating him. This computer was in control of a vault, and it needed Edward's skills, as well as his DNA. Ah, no, DNA. Edward's DNA was then used to create a serum which the computer forced onto the people of Vault 28. They were trying to stop it, but they injected him with something that eventually took his mind. When I found him, there wasn't much left. I'm sorry. What the fuck?
Wow. This is an awful lot to take in. My Edward. He was alive and below my feet all these years. You know, it's crazy, but I think I always knew he wasn't too far. I could just feel it, you know? Well, they're not the answers I was hoping for. But they are answers. I guess all that's left now is for me to finally leave this depressing place. Thanks, kid. I was wrong about you. It's not much, but here's some caps.
Okay, so that guy is going to wrap it up for this St. Patrick's Day special. And the very first Fallout 4 video that I have done on the channel for the Absent Ghoul quest mod. So, I really hope y'all have enjoyed this. And happy St. Patrick's Day to all of you fine lads and lassies out there. Take care, and I will see y'all next time. Peace out, hombres.